Well, let's give some credit to SoftBank. I mean, I think they've made some very good investments over the last 4 years in the Vision Fund that people didn't appreciate. And we have seen them now coming out with evidence of the values there. So, you know, we should give them some credit where it's due. I mean, I do think the investments they've made in DoorDash in particular, you know, have benefited from the last few months of COVID behavior change. But these have been some very smart thinking across multiple geographies along the right themes. So SoftBank has a real right to be happy about these results and the way the market is accepting them.
Right. You do not believe that the timing has something to do with it?
Well, clearly we're seeing a risk-on environment, and SoftBank is a case of a company which has, you know, taken on borrowings over the past to invest in growth, and they certainly benefit in this kind of market environment. But they have put some very sensible bets on in areas where consumer behavior are changing. I mean, e-commerce has been an area where we've seen acceleration across Asia the last few years, but it's not just one market, it's every market that they have found the ability to invest in market leaders, and that's really been paying off for them this last quarter.
It's currently sitting for the share price at 9782 yen, and I see you've got a target price, Oliver, of 11,647, and you remain a buyer. What is the key risk then to achieving that target price?
Key risks on SoftBank, obviously, a lot of their assets are overseas, so a stronger yen tends to be negative for the share price. Otherwise, if you were to see some kind of major value rotation that might be taken bad for growth stocks, which SoftBank is clearly one of the best in Japan. So those would be the risks we would be cautious about.